The Green Bay Packers won a nail-biter last night, beating the San Francisco 49ers 30-28. After leading the whole game, the Packers fell down 28-27 with just 37 seconds left to go and no timeouts for the Pack. But that was enough for Aaron Rodgers, who connected with Devontae Adams twice to bring the Pack into field goal range. Mason Crosby booted through a 51-yarder to win it as time expired. And just for fun, let's take a look at number 12 as it sailed through. To me, Jeff, that looks like a guy who still likes football. Packers are home next Sunday against the Pittsburgh Steelers. Crandon schools will be closed tomorrow through Friday in response to a growing number of illnesses at the schools. School District Administrator Larry Palabicki cited rising COVID, RSV, and hand, foot, and mouth disease cases in a Facebook Live message this morning. This district custodial staff will be deep cleaning the buildings this week. Meanwhile, students will do virtual learning. And next Monday, all staff and students will return and be required to wear masks. Masks will be mandatory at least through the end of October. Some Native American leaders are gathering in Wausau tonight after a Wausau West teacher dressed in a Native American costume during class. This picture was taken by an Ojibwe student in that classroom. The costume was worn during a U.S. history lesson. Leaders with the Lacta Flambeau, Ojibwe, Oneida Nation, and Ho-Chunk Nation are holding a 4:30 press conference outside of John Muir Middle School in Wausau. They will then speak at the 5 p.m. school board meeting inside the school. Some Afghans may be resettling in Wausau. A local refugee agency is hosting a webinar this week for anyone interested in learning more about that process. Nearly 13,000 Afghan refugees are in Fort McCoy in Wisconsin right now, and some are planned to resettle in the Wausau area. The Wausau-based resettlement organization New Beginnings for Refugees will host the virtual event on Thursday at 6:30 p.m. It is billed as a public education event about what the upcoming resettlement process will look like. Again, Thursday this week, register for the event at newbeginningswi.org.